2009, our family went on a trip to Mom's parents. I've never been there, although I've been in Russia many times. They live in Siberia. As usual, it was a 10-hour plane ride, but we get used to it. This time, our main interest was the railroad trip. My parents told me that we are going to stay aboard for 3 days, one way. We were going to pass a lot of Russian cities and territories. We were going to cross a good half of Russia. There were Ural Mountains ahead of us. There was the legendary Siberia waiting for us. There were also Siam Mountains that we had to cross by car since there is no railroad to the city of Kazul, where my grandparents are. I was very excited, and here is where my story begins. My dad can call himself a very experienced railroad traveler, but his experience was in the past. He had his last big trip about 15 years ago. He wishes he could get back to that time and compare his feelings. What has been changed? He would like to share his memory with me, his son Michael. If it wasn't for my dad, I wouldn't know anything about trains. My dad says he was pleased by the improved look of Russian railroads. It seemed that they got much more maintenance. It also seemed to him that railroad authorities got unbelievable amount of green paint and could not do better than paint all related infrastructure in this magical color. We were interested to learn everything we could find out. How did the workers connect railroad tracks to cross ties? How did they deliver luggage? How did diesel locomotives look like? And how big is a real steam locomotive? During train stops, we were observing restless workers. They were knocking on axle boxes, trying to see if there were any cracks. How did we eat during this long ride? As usual, there was free boiled water 24/7. In general, people do not count a lot on the diet, mainly because of two reasons. First, it is a little bit expensive. Secondly, there is not much of a choice over there. One night, my dad and I went to the diner for dinner. As my dad mentioned, while he was studying the menu, the waiter took a shortcut and told him that in reality, he may make a choice from only two dishes. That is why my dad is saying nothing has been changed in this business. It hasn't been changed since the last 40 years. Small street vendors are still thriving. Our train car was not too bad. It was built about 20 years ago in Germany. We were told that everything has changed these days. They build domestic passenger cars. Well, maybe. We may have seen those cars a couple times during our 6-day round trip. They have a different painting. I was greatly surprised by our restroom. The air conditioner is also not a big deal. We opened our window to protect ourselves from the heat, but the window would not close back. We were passing by big cities and small villages. We had sunrises and sunsets. We were rolling and rolling. There was always something new to discover.